This is an arm. This is skin on an arm. You can itch it, moisturize it, tattoo it, stretch it, peel it. Ugh, that's gross. And you can make a baby from it.
Hello, you've reached the office of Dr. X. For a skin biopsy to create eggs, press 1. For a skin biopsy to create sperm, press 2. For all other services, please stay on the line.
This is obviously a fake message on a fake doctor's fake answering machine. But it could be real in the next 40 years, according to Dr. Hank Greeley, professor of law and genetics at Stanford University, and author of The End of Sex and the Future of Human Reproduction. So your book is titled End of Sex. Do you really think that people are going to stop having sex?
No, in fact, my strongest prediction is that in 20 to 40 years, people will still have sex. But when they want to make babies, they'll go to a lab. What's going to change that will be ways to take skin cells and turn them into what are called induced pluripotent stem cells.
The amazing thing about induced pluripotent stem cells is that they can be reprogrammed into any type of cell, including cells to create eggs or sperm. This entire process is called in vitro gametogenesis, or IVG, not to be confused with the common procedure known as IVF. Here's the thing. So far, we've really only done it in mice, but there's ongoing studies that suggest that this could be the future of human reproduction. By creating eggs and sperm outside of the human body, IVG will allow us to push nature's reproductive boundaries. With this technology, virtually anyone, from post-menopausal women to same-sex couples, may be able to create biological families through a simple skin biopsy. So, how far are we from making this a reality for prospective parents?
I figure it's about somewhere between 5 to 10 years to get proof of principle before somebody's able to make human eggs and human sperm.
And with an added decade or two for safety testing, we could be seeing the widespread use of this technology in about 40 years, according to Greeley. 40 years may seem like a long way off, but this technology has ethical challenges that we should start wrestling with now. One of the biggest challenges is that IVG could make it infinitely easier for parents to select certain traits in their kids, pushing us closer to the much-feared designer babies hysteria that surrounds most fertility research. Embryo selection is already being done with IVF. Doctors fertilize a bunch of eggs and look at the genetic makeup of those embryos. Then, they pick the most viable one.
Right now, the biggest obstacle for somebody who wants to make a choice about an embryo in the sense of wanting a particular trait and trait selection is the number of eggs that can be retrieved from a woman. So one of the advantages of IVG is that we could derive basically an unlimited amount of eggs.
And an unlimited amount of eggs means we could produce an unlimited amount of embryos for prospective parents to choose from. Right now, parents typically screen embryos for health reasons, but that could change as embryo selection technology becomes more advanced. We could even see IVG combined with gene editing.
Then suddenly we're kind of catering to a much more eugenic impulse among people towards having, if not the perfect baby, the best baby there can be. Many people think it would be great to eradicate serious health conditions, but members of the disability community understandably feel as though these are targeting them.
And while these new technologies feel like unknown territory, it's also strangely familiar. The same conversation was in play with IVF. When IVF became available in the 1970s, concerned citizens were afraid of a slippery slope, where parents could select their baby's gender and where babies could gestate in laboratories. And they're right, that slope exists, and we're on it. But is it something to fear? IVF has allowed 8 million of our family and friends to exist, and like IVF, in vitro gametogenesis could be a game-changing technology for millions of people around the world. Terms like reproductive technology, IVF, and IVG are clinical terms that can detach us from what's really going on here. We're creating future generations of human beings that will carry on our traits, legacy, and ideals long after we're gone. How we create those human beings, and whether we do it safely and ethically, is a paramount responsibility that we all share. As skin cell embryos inch their way from the lab to the crib, the conversations we have over the next decades will influence how this technology shapes the future of humanity. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, check out our website for more great content. And don't forget to subscribe to Freethink.